that piece about trust, when we're talking about military leadership or leadership in general, that's what I found from my time in the SEAL teams, is that building that trust, both with those beneath you and above you in the chain of command, there's nothing more important than that. And if you do not tell the truth, they will know, particularly the enlisted guys that you're in charge of, they will 100% know, and you will lose all credibility. The telling the truth, being honest, giving your honest assessment, both up and down the chain of command, there's nothing more important than that. And interesting, when we're talking about this accountability piece, you're probably familiar with Lieutenant Colonel Paul Yingling in that article he wrote, A Failure of Generalship, when he says, as matters stand now, a private who loses a rifle suffers far greater consequences than a general who loses a war. And that continued. He wrote that in 2007. And that we're seeing that play out today in congressional testimony. As we're recording this, we have generals in front of Congress. And once again, if you lost a rifle as a private, big trouble. You lose a war, and you see now all these rifles that we left behind. I mean, there's nothing that illustrates the difference between accountability at the junior level and the senior level more than that.
Absolutely. And Yingling was actually, I think, more focused on the war in Iraq at that point.
Exactly.
It's even more applicable to Afghanistan. But that's one reason why they keep talking about progress, right? If you insist we're making progress, nobody can say you lost the war. But there's another character in this play, if you will, that we haven't talked about that much, but that's Congress. And they're the ones who are supposed to be exercising oversight and ensuring accountability, not only with the war itself and all the money that we're spending, which they authorize. But I think one issue with Congress over the years in watching people testify who are military commanders is they're overly deferential to some of our leaders in uniform, particularly under Obama's term. There was this, you know, understandable sense of gratitude to military leaders during a time of war, particularly when we had the most troops overseas. But I think at the same time, they lost their sense of skepticism and their responsibility to ask tough questions. There was a lot of deference whenever people like General Petraeus or General McChrystal or others would go testify before Congress. Lawmakers would call them heroes, and that's all fine. But when it came time to asking those tough questions like, well, what do you mean progress? And what about this and this and this? And that went missing. And in recent years, really, Congress stopped asking questions altogether in Afghanistan. They just stopped paying attention. So I'm glad they're having hearings now, but I hope it's not just the usual partisan finger pointing and they don't just focus on the end of the war. Somebody really needs to take a look at what went wrong over 20 years, a really honest, clear-eyed assessment that doesn't have all the political shouting involved, but just, almost something like the 9/11 Commission did after the September 11th attacks, where they ended up having public testimony that was pretty sober-minded and pretty serious. And they wrote a book that to this day people can read to see what mistakes were made that enabled 9/11 to happen. I hope we can get something like that for Afghanistan.
Yeah, I hope so too. Actually, I called for that a few weeks ago on my social media account. I took that 9/11 Commission report, that initial impetus behind it, and I shifted it around a little bit, and then I posted it saying that exact same thing, that we need an accounting of what happened over the last 20 years so we can learn those lessons forward from it, kind of like we did with the 9/11 Commission report.